Of year again. My name is Maureen. Welcome to MANJÈ La Kayè. It's DBS's annual Creole cooking show, and I'm here with Chef Nico. Of course, his government name. If you're writing his check, you're gonna have to write Nicodemus
Joseph. Yeah.
Joseph. But for us, we affectionately know him as Chef Nico. So today, Chef is going to be walking us through one of his amazing dishes. Chef, of course, is no stranger to the land of St. Lucia. If you've been following what's going on, this is Top Chef right here. This is a man that has mastered the art of culinary classics, because you learn how to do the Creole stuff, which is our authentic stuff.
That's right.
And you put your own flair to it.
That's right.
So this morning we're about to find out or get a taste of how it is that you actually put those awesomeness together. Chef Nico, how are you today?
I'm great.
Oh, yeah. You look great.
Yeah.
Inside of you smells amazing, by the way.
Thank you.
You know, just to let you guys know, this year we've got a title sponsor. We've partnered with PCD, that's Peter and Company Distributors, and the product on showcase this morning is going to be Dutch Lady. So our chef right here is going to be using the Dutch Lady product in whatever he is going to be creating, that masterpiece here with us today. So Chef, what are we doing today? What are you going to be cooking up today?
All right, perfect. So today we'll be cooking some fish, and we'll do some breadfruit also.
Ooh.
Which is Creole, and small fish. So we'll do a breadfruit and small fish mash with some grilled fish with some souskay. Simple love, as you said, with a twist.
Absolutely. Well, I can't wait to dig in.
Sure.
So let's go. Let's dig into this.
All right. So we'll start with our fish, because we need our fish to marinate for at least maybe half an hour. So with here we have kawang. That's a pattern name for it.
I love this fish.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite fish.
Yes. It's a beautiful fish, and that's one of the cheapest fish.
That's quite affordable, isn't it?
Yes. Right. Most of the time it's like $5, you know, a pound.
These are two healthy ones you've got there.
That's right.
Wonderful.
So we're going to butterfly the fish. The head, so we'll cut into it.
Wonderful.
Get the head also.
Are we going to be cooking the head as part of this as well?
Yeah.
Oh, I like that.
Yes.
Most people like to take off when you get to the part of executive chef. They take out the head. I don't like that. I like the head.
Yeah.
Absolutely love the head.
Especially now it's Creole.
It's Creole.
So we have
you
to do
the
head. The way that our grandparents used to do.
Absolutely.
Right?
No, I'm starting to love this already.
Yes.
Certainly starting to love this already. And I've seen you going ahead and prep up all of your stuff before.
Yes.
So we got that there. We'll
right,
cover
right.
that.
So right. Talk to you in a while. Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
So it's very simple to fillet. It's not that complicated. You split the head, you start from the inside and go through the bones and then the flesh. And here we go. Take it off.
There you go.
Alright. So we have our fish there. So over here we have, as you said, most of the ingredients already prepped.
Right?
So we have mango there, so we're going to do a mango.
Oh, I thought it was
sushi.
Pineapple. So we're dealing with mango today, not pineapple.
Okay.
I had it wrong.
Yes. So we have seasoning pepper, we have chives, we have lime, we have bell peppers, we have the red, yellow, green, then we have red onion, we have the white onion, we have garlic, and parsley.
Is your garlic in oil?
Yeah, so normally you put it after you chop it, you put it in oil so that it turns green. You know, most of the times if you read it like this, it turns green, you know. So
that's something for me to walk away with today.
Yes.
Absolutely.
All right. So you ready? Salt, don't forget. It's like 2 pinches of salt.
Right.
You don't want to go too heavy with the salt. Some black pepper.
Nice.
All right. Oil is very important.
Why is it so important?
Yeah, you know, if you do it without oil, like, you know, it's not marinating the fish good enough. So with the oil, with the seasoning too, it will give it a very good blend.
Nice.
Okay. Not much, just a little touch of it.
Uh-huh.
We need garlic in there.
Alright,
so that's the step. Don't be scared to use your hands, you know?
Right, well, that part I like. I like to get my hands dirty in the kitchen, you know,
right.
In the kitchen. You've got to prove you're in the kitchen now.
There we go. Wow. So that's the best part of it. So it's there, it's going to marinate for half an hour. So then, you know, it's going to have a beautiful flavor when you're ready to cook it.
Right.
Yeah. So you're going to wrap it and put it in the fridge.
Okay, so you have not put any of the other ingredients in it. Just your oil, your black pepper, your salt,
right,
your oil.
Yes,
and marinate
it with lime juice, and after cooking, you put lime juice also.
Okay. Yeah? Wonderful. So this goes over there.
Yes.
Marinate for a little bit. So guys, we are here in the kitchen with Chef Nico, sponsored of course by PCD. And we are doing the Sustidious cooking show. We are learning how to do some sustai. Well, I've been trying to find out how to do sustai for all my life being in St.Lucia. So hopefully I get to leave here with some knowledge today.
Right.
Chef Nico is here walking us through this process right now.
DBS Manjè Lakay, brought to you by Peter & Company Distribution, agents for Dutch Lady Milk. Did you know that a 200 milliliter glass of milk contains 240 milligrams of calcium? 365 grams of broccoli also contains 240 milligrams of calcium.
So
So we add it to the pan.
Also, we are about to put that breakfast in now.
Right.
Soften it up, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So remember, it's very important when you dice your breakfast to put it in water, because if you don't put it in water, it will get black. So you need to put it in water.
Right.
So that can be a beautiful color.
Nice.
So we leave it in there for maybe half an hour. And don't forget saltfish.
Are you putting it in one time?
No. The saltfish, you have to put it separate. And then boil so that I can get the salt off.
Right. Sweet, but you've already.
That's new, and I boil a whole big piece of saltfish, and then I take it out, so this is nice, so you get most of the salt like that. Yeah, exactly. Right, so I'm gonna let that steam there for a bit, no salt, nothing, set it boil, take the saltfish boil, keep it half an hour, and we'll get back to it. Now in the meantime, you can start working on our subscribe.
Work with me, guys. Yeah, I've taken all the pictures. three.
Perfect. All right.
There you go.
Put in oil now. All right. Sim. Three.
Three oil. Come, guys. Work with us here. We're here with Chef Nico, guys. I'm learning to make souska. That's two. Right.
Ooh. All right. So, secondly, salt, black pepper, and a little water.
Right. Oh, we got black pepper here, and we've got salt here.
Yeah.
All right. So, are we measuring
yeah.
as well?
Black pepper, just 2 pinch. You know, so
2 pinch.
You can use a spoon, but you're just
a little. You guide me.
Just put it in.
Put it in it.
Yeah.
Like this.
Yeah.
That's too much.
Pinch, yeah. And half of that.
This.
Yeah.
A little
yeah.
more. Show back some more.
Okay,
that's enough. Okay, there you go. Get it in there.
With the salt now?
Right. Oh, I feel like I'm an executive chef right now.
So let's go maybe half.
That's
perfect.
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 You heard that, right. guys? Perfect.
Yes. And we'll add some water to it now.
Oh.
Okay, can we mix it together?
You guys are getting this, right? All right. It smells so good. It smells really good. Wow. And all of these things, you've gone to school to learn them after you realized you had a passion in here? Or most of it was self-taught?
Yeah, I did some course. We presented some dishes in cooking competition. You know, Miami, Puerto Rico.
We're going to come to that
America,
in a minute. Come into that in a while, you know. I want to go there with you full time.
Yeah.
But, you know, what I want is to get the sense of, you know, I want to get the feel of that little boy in Bhutto.
Right. Yes.
You know, that I want to take you there for. I want you to take me there first.
Sure.
You know, around the kitchen, learning all of these little things. Because
right.
a lot of these things, you could go to all the culinary school you want, but
right.
to have that magnificent touch,
passion,
you have to have
passion,
that, yes, right. from the grandma in the right. kitchen, with the hand
right.
in hand and doing your this. You
yeah.
know, you're not getting it right. Is it good? It's perfect.
Amazing.
Oh, let's see this. Did I do well?
You did a good job.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh my. This is good.
Yeah.
I'm proud of me.
Yeah, that's right. Good job.
I'm proud of me. Oh, this is good. All right, so what do we do now? We put this to rest.
We put it to rest,
mm-hmm.
and you know that the more it stays, the stronger it gets.
Right.
Better it is.
Right.
You know?
Everything's going to marinate nicely,
right.
and the flavors are going to start blending with each other.
Right.
So you put this away.
Fridge.
Awesome. Mm. Wow. Guys, I'm loving this. I'm absolutely loving this. Not time yet to check on our breakfast.
Yeah.
Certainly. Let's check on the breakfast now. Absolutely. So the souska is asked to put on the fish after it's done?
Right.
Right. Oh, let's check on our breakfast.
It's boiling.
Not yet there.
It's there.
Well, you cut it up in small bits.
It's
not going to
take long. Half an hour, we should be ready. Our soft fish is ready, as you said, it's already flake and you know, like dressing some water and everything. So right now we're boiling it. So it's, you know, the salt basically got already. So you just strain it and leave it in a little bit of water.
Right. Do you remove all of the salt or just a little?
Just a little.
Right.
Just a little. Because you don't want to put no more salt in it.
Right, because I was thinking maybe that's a technique to take all the salt out and then you put your flavor in. Because
yes.
it's just salt as it
yeah.
stands.
Yeah.
So you put your own flavor in.
That's right.
I don't know, it's my thought. I'm
yes.
not sure. You're going to guide me. That's why we're
yes.
here. And I'm still going back with you. You know, I want to talk about
yes.
you in that. This part of it as well. You got to make sure. Okay, we strain this out.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not it.
Perfect, yeah.
Yes.
So you get rid of the
Doesn't
water.
Doesn't make a difference in the type of quality of saltfish?
No.
Yeah. Saltfish is
saltfish.
Okay. Alright, good. Yeah, I was thinking that you made me a difference.
No,
I didn't. Actually, okay,
right.
So we lay our saltfish down.
Perfect. So what we're going to do now, as we're waiting for the breakfast, we're going to saute the saltfish.
Right.
Yeah? So we're resting.
What is it? Look, listen, in your kitchen, because I'm invading your kitchen as a chef, as an executive chef, do you have certain kitchen etiquette, that things that will piss you off in your kitchen? So I need to know. I know how people, when they're in the kitchen,
right.
certain things are okay. If you're in the kitchen with me, stay clear of this, do this, do that. What do you right. have some of those?
Yeah, with the kitchen, you know, whenever you know you maintain the house a part of the kitchen, mm-hmm. that's the fun of it. You know, make sure the kitchen is clean mm-hmm. at all times. You know, after you've done something, you put it in the area, you have your steward washing it, putting it over there, the floor is properly mopped, you know? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's what gets me excited in the kitchen. Right. And I have a very clean kitchen.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. What is the do's and don'ts if you're in the kitchen with you?
Okay, so in the kitchen, I don't like people to talk when I have a lot of when I have work to do. So, you know, we focus on the work first, mm-hmm. and after the work is done, we can crack our joke again, you know?
Right.
But it's afterwards, you know?
Yeah. Right. Some people don't like a lot of people in the kitchen. Is
yes.
that you or you prefer?
I don't like a big team in the kitchen. I love a team that's ready to push, you know?
Just right. make it because happen, at your level, yeah. you need a team.
Yes.
You need people
yes.
around you in the kitchen. Yes.
Alright, so sauteed swordfish now. Alright, okay. I'm gonna send sauteed swordfish. Our swordfish is right there.
Very well.
We're going to use our oil.
Okay, oil. What else do you need?
Peppers, onions.
Peppers? Onions, all of the bell peppers?
Yes.
Okay, all three.
And some seasoned peppers.
Alright, there you go. Okay. That's it?
That's it.
There you go. Ooh. Ah, well. Right.
All right, so we add the oil in there. So, you know, after the pan is hot, make sure the pan is hot before you add anything to it.
Okay.
And the second step is your oil. So, okay. afterwards, you're going to add the seasoning, some onions in there.
Right. Ooh. This is nice. Right.
Pepper.
Yeah. So, we're about to saute your salt fish.
That's right.
Yeah.
Got it.
Nice.
The most important?
Yes,
seasoned pepper. I know you love
the
that.
Local stuff. I love a seasoned pepper. I love a local seasoned. Wow. Oh, I've always wanted to do this.
Yeah.
I'm not going to try today. I've always been so fascinated by that. Is it a skill?
It is.
How do you get it?
Okay, so let me show you. Huh? Like
how
this.
Do you get?
Ooh. All right, so you have to leave the end of the pan close to the fire, and then you saute. You need close to the fire. You see?
Oh, okay. And it come back.
Yeah, really.
Right. I can do it.
So leave it a little bit close to the fire. Why do it? You know, and the oil.
It just jump with the oil yeah. and the fire. Oh, okay.
Well, you get there. You get there.
Don't play with me now.
Yeah, you get there.
Wow. It's a flick of the wrist, though.
That's right. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
This
so,
is so cool.
Caramelized.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Smells so good.
Perfect.
One thing is in your kitchen smells really
yes.
good.
Yes.
Every different step is
going to
put your
other
salt. I was asking about the etiquette because it crossed my mind to live here and I thought, is that a do or don't?
No, there's no place to rest in the kitchen.
No, you don't rest in the kitchen. Exactly. So we're learning the etiquette as well as
yes.
we go along. You add some more oil.
Right, just a bit more oil. And let it caramelize there just for about like maybe 2 minutes.
1 minute.
Okay. Take a little wet food.
Right. Wow. Okay, so again we're going back to the butter days in the kitchen. Everybody else all playing,
right?
And you just in the kitchen really because you was a foodie.
I was a foodie. I was a foodie, you know, really.
We can say all of this derived from the fact that you liked food.
I love food. I love food.
You did know, you know at the time though, that you were going to end up in a field related? Were you taking along that line? No.
Tell you what, it never crossed my mind. It never
you
crossed
just
my mind. So I just
following the food.
Yeah, it's just like, you know, I left school and I had nothing much to do. No, not much choices at the time.
Mm-hmm.
I get a steward job, so I'm like, okay, let me take it for that.
Right.
And then get into that kitchen and seeing those type of, you know, the environment and the way the chef is cooking the food and fire it, and the waitress have to go and feed it. And it's like, come on, let's do it, you know?
Yeah.
I'm really excited.
Right. And you were just there washing up the dishes at
yes.
the time.
Yes, yes.
And
yes.
this excited you. Who would have known?
Exactly.
Who would have known?
Exactly. And then I said to myself, tell you what? This is your dream, you know.
That's
this
you
is your dream, and I just go from there, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
But you were also very, very, very. You were a go-getter because to be in the kitchen washing mm-hmm. the and to tell yourself you go and put yourself in the people thing, and normally
right.
people get vexed about this thing. But I guess they viewed it differently because it was divine.
Yeah. And back in the days, you know, this is the way a lot of us get promoted, you know. Yeah. Had no choice. Go to the kitchen.
So how long did you spend as
a steward? For 2 months.
What?
2 months.
And then that was it?
And the chef saw the potential in me and he was like, okay, tell you what, that area is not for you anymore. So Let's go to the stove. Yeah.
Walk me to that part.
Yes, yes.
So that's too much. Did you okay, we put in it some higher fire on the
pan. Yes, we did.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Walk me to that part. So 2 months you're there and it's no, it's not where you belong.
Yes, so
it's all the potential.
The way it started, you know, take a life with you. 5 minutes.
Yeah. But our sawfish is good.
Yeah, our sawfish is good. So just waiting for the breakfast so that we can do our steps, you know.
Right. So, okay, we're not ready yet for the fish. Oops. Not ready for our fish yet, is it?
Yeah, we'll do our fish now. So as the breakfast.
Oh, we're doing it now. Okay, great. Right, so there were you, and they took you out from there and brought you alongside him personally?
Yeah, so as I said, if I started watching the series, then, you know, I'm rushing to do my work, so I want to do my work to help the chefs. So the chefs, at the time, that was in Chester Hotel.
Right.
So the breakfast is upstairs,
yes,
and then they come in down to the beach for lunch, you know, so they have to prep up their lunch afterwards.
Right.
So what I used to do was to see what they're saying, learn from them, and when they come down, the prep is already there.
You did it.
The prep, you know?
Then, you know, they must have loved that. You see it?
That's really
okay.
Started.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then what happened there? Because if you were handling yourself like that, from that angle, it was only a matter of time now, yeah?
Yes, yes.
Before they put you into something bigger.
Yeah. And you're so right about it. And then from there, you know, I worked there for 8 years, learned as much as possible, and then I decided to move on, you know? All right, so we're getting ready for the fish as we're talking. Let me just grab the fish.
Let's grab the fish.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
And then we're going to use some limes and fish with some lime juice. Before.
Wonderful. So we're grabbing the fish. For those of you who are just joining us, we're here on DBS. It's our annual cooking show. MANJÈ is Creole, and we're getting you set for the Creole Heritage Month. We're going to grab some limes. We're about to do our fish now.
Right.
Remember, we prepped the fish before.
Yes.
So I'm here with it. Remember, we prepped the fish before. Mm-hmm. So we're just taking it off from the fridge. And we about
to add some lime juice to the fridge.
We added lime to it.
Mm-hmm.
Just squeeze it in there.
Squeeze it in.
Okay. Oops. Can I drop this in there? Drop this? No? Okay. Right. There you go. About three of these.
Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. This is some healthy limes. They got a lot of juice in there. Oh, did you get them locally?
Yes.
On the market? Wow, you have to go early.
Yeah.
That's it. Yeah?
That's it.
Wonderful.
All right, great.
Huh?
So, our hot pan is, let me check pan is hot as
normal. It's got to be really, really hot.
Okay, a little bit of oil to it.
Awesome. Right. Stir it around.
That's right.
Pop. Yes.
There you are.
Awesome.
So, put it a little bit higher because we need the pressure.
Wonderful.
Let the breadfruit again.
Breadfruit seems to be okay now.
Oh, perfect. It's getting there.
Okay.
Right.
Awesome.
Good. Come on,
right.
All right, so we'll add the fish now. Start cooking the fish, right?
Very well. I'm going to watch very much attention to this one now, because I know normally people say fish don't need a lot of fire.
That's right.
They don't need fish to overcook. It's like everything from there. Nice.
And you know, the funny thing about fish, you know, you don't cook it really dry from the outside.
Mm-hmm.
Because after you cook it, you rest it there, it cooks in the inside by itself. Slowly.
Oh, that's a new thing. I never knew that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so you don't try to cook fish too?
Yes, yes. When you leave it for a little bit, you know, especially the time you'll be using it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so when you rest it there, it's cooked. It's going to cook in the inside slowly.
Oh,
so you have to prepare it.
I love this. It's wonderful. Right. Mm. Mm. Right. With a breakfast open on
it.
Right, so we were talking. I want the full story.
Yes,
it was quite interesting.
Yeah, so after 8 years, my friend from the smartness can be built with her. You know, a higher position if I give my money.
Okay.
And then, you know, a couple of years after, I decided, okay, tell you what, cashews is the place for me to cashews, you know.
You come up here.
Yeah.
You come up to the cashews area.
Yes.
Come up as an employee or you keep on your own guard?
Yeah, as a chef de partage, so I was a small supervisor.
Oh.
And that was it. Just start cooking from there, you know. Yeah. And then I went to Windham. I don't know if you remember Windham.
Yeah,
after Windham, I went to Royal Solution. I stayed there for a couple of years. Then I went to Capuzon. I stayed Capuzon for about 10 years. And I decided to move on.
What do you say? How long have you been in this industry?
Yeah.
All your life?
I would say about maybe 20 something years. Yeah. Yeah. It's been a while. Eh? Yeah, all my life.
Do you see yourself in any other fields? No.
No.
Where you belong.
Yeah.
So you found your niche.
Yeah.
That's where Chef Nico belongs.
That's right.
So that's
where you can see the beautiful colors. Golden brown, yeah.
It looks so good.
Mm-hmm. That will taste so nice if it's just fire.
Wow. That looks so juicy. Yeah. It looks quite juicy. Right. So bearing in mind what you said, you don't cook this all the way through.
Right.
You're gonna be resting it just out. How do you know?
Okay, so you point on the fish, you check by the side of it there. So you go see the side of it, you get like a golden color.
Brown,
you know?
Right.
So that means it's time for it to turn, you know?
Time to turn,
yeah.
Right. And then you turn, and once it gets to the other side, you can take it out.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right. Wonderful. So, wow.
Right, so you more to defilate the liquid oil, because remember you don't put a lot of oil. You only just add the liquid oil to it, right?
Right.
So you don't want to put a lot of oil because you're not frying it, you're grating it, right?
Nice. Okay. Good. You're not frying.
Yeah, you're grating.
You don't load it with the oil.
Okay. Let's check our breath again. Mm.
Oh, the smell.
Yes,
the aroma is just... I'm ready to eat, you know, chef.
I know.
I'm ready to eat, you know.
Yeah,
is it the best to eat, you know?
Yeah, that's really nice and tough, man.
Oh, awesome. So, restrain this now?
Yes. Alright, so why do we have the fish on the fire? We restrain our breath first.
Okay. Oh, do I monitor the fish?
Hey. Don't eat it.
If anything goes wrong with the fish, please
it's
know.
You,
Yeah, please know. I'm monitoring. Oh, this is my time now. The fish is not supposed to overcook. Yeah. There you go. Have my stocking. Oh, nice.
How are we doing, Nisha?
Very well, actually. I think I'm doing very well. Oh, you can't seem good. No? Not yet?
Oh.
Yeah, I took out the skin.
Okay.
Is that okay? Are we gonna leave this pot on?
Yes.
Yeah.
So we leave it hot.
Okay.
So we go.
Nice. All right. So our fish is ready.
Yeah.
We lay that to the side. Yeah. Right.
See,
look so good. Golden.
Yeah, so we put it into the fish.
Wow, this looks so good. See this?
Yes.
This is awesome. Oh, what are we putting in there now? The salt fish has to go down?
So we're going to add the rest of the fish.
Oh, the rest of the fish. We have more fish. Nice. Wonderful.
I know you have to share with me.
I'm not going to share with you. I'm sorry. I'm not sharing with anyone. Not even our camera guys are going to be disturbing this here today. Sorry, guys. Nice, but not today. Not when it comes to kawang fish. It's too sad. It's so prepared by Chef Nico. We're going to have a problem today, guys. I buy you food down the road. That's okay, guys. I'm going to get my camera guys' food down the road because we're not sharing our sister's food.
Right, so we're putting our mash now, yeah?
Right. Okay, good. We use the same pot. We add a little oil. Okay. All right. We're going in.
Saltfish.
The saltfish first. Mm, okay.
And the kitchen is lovely, right?
It smells so good. This aroma is awesome. You know, I'm not even feeling the heat right now. It smells so good.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. That already looks so good.
Yeah, imagine. Mm. That can be a side dish, right?
That's a dish by itself, isn't it?
Yeah. So, we'll add one of our main ingredients in there.
Very well. What's that? Okay, and this is our product, yes. This is our product.
Right.
Now, there's some very significant fun facts about Dutch lady milk. I think st.lucia is the only, or Dutch lady st.lucia, or PCP st.lucia is the only country that celebrates World Milk Month. There's a World Milk Day, but I think that we're the only person that celebrate a World Milk Month, and that's the month of June. Did you know that, sir?
Well, imagine I'm going to touch you now.
But that's my area there. Yeah, that's you teaching me and I'm teaching you today.
Yeah.
So that is our product. choice for today. That's our product on display for today. This is the star product of this article.
And I really know that.
So are you going to put it in here? Well, tell me why.
I'm using it for my cocoa tea. And a lot of people do that. They use the box milk or the other regular milk. But that milk is giving the cocoa tea a beautiful flavor.
Really?
Even the porridge. Even the porridge, you use that now. Yeah.
So we got top 10 here working with. Mm-hmm. Endorsed by the executive chef himself, Dutch Lady Milk. So you grab yours the next time you enter the supermarket. Okay, so we add a little bit of that. Chef, this looks like it's going to be a good thing.
Yes, yes, wow. This is good already.
This is good, this is good. Yeah. Devon, did you get close up on this? Oh, that looks good. So, this is going to give you a nice creamy sort of mash. So we're going to be blending up this in a bit, crushing it up.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
So, make sure your fan is low.
Blow it down now, yeah. Wow. I can't wait to see the I'm looking at the Dutch Lady Milk in there and it looks so rich and creamy. You're seeing it?
That
it's creamy.
That one is a creamy one. And you see
and look how creamy it is. Yeah. You mean there's the next one?
Yeah.
Oh, this is good. Right. And you got all your proteins and calcium in there as well. That's really good, isn't it? Very well. Loaded with food. And chef has said that's his favorite, eh? The chef has said that's what's up. That's what's up. Right. Should I turn it a little bit, chef?
Yes.
Where's my spoon? Oops. Oh, I don't know. I'm going to try this. Okay. All right, guys. I'm trying to keep this going. Ooh. This looks so good. Now you can actually see the richness after the Dutch Lady Milk has gone in there. Should I load the fire a little bit? Oh. Listen, I don't know how you gotta be a real professional, because right now I'm looking at the fish over there and I'm thinking, how can you manage everything? Watch the fish. I think I'm with the wrong thing. Oh, we covered it already. Okay, great.
All right, great. You did a good job. Looking nice. So if I need an assistant, I know where to get
me. You know where to get me. And please
don't
call.
Don't tell me what's that, eh?
No, that's fine.
It's a secret.
That is all right. I know we mash it. How nice and creamy it looks.
Yes.
Does it matter the breakfast? Or what
yeah, you can do
breakfast is what do you do? Do you take breakfast at a little ripe, or it depends on what you want?
Yeah, it's supposed to be mature. You know, you
mature.
Want it to be ripe.
Right.
Yeah. So you can do it with green food, you can do it with plantain, you can do it with potato.
Okay.
You know? So it's up to you.
Mashed breakfast, green Creole. Creole is breakfast for me.
Exactly.
I love breakfast.
Exactly.
I love a breakfast. Oh, this looks good.
You might need to abuse any of the
milk. No, you instantly saw that.
That one, yeah?
Yeah, you instantly saw that thick richness once you added that Dutch Lady Milk.
Look how beautiful it looks.
It looks good. It smells great. I can't wait to taste it. I'm ready to eat, you know. That's a problem with me. I'm supposed to be doing one thing here. This is good. Look how this looks. Oh, look at this. Rich and nice. Oh, creamy. Oh, we get to taste?
We have to taste.
You gotta taste, guys. Oh.
Yes.
Wow. This is good. Wow. Oh, this is great. This is awesome.
What do you think?
This is lovely.
You know, you cannot go wrong with that milk.
It's rich. It's filling. Like, I could eat this now. Like, it's like lunch. Like a full meal. Yeah, you should get a little jealous over there. No, give me some a bit. Not for the fish, though,
but. All right, so the last two ingredients we're going to add to it is a little kick. So we're going to use some hot sauce.
Oh, okay. Into this?
Yeah.
Okay. I was wondering where the hot sauce is going.
Right.
Okay. Wow. I've never seen that. Should we mix it in there?
Yeah. Just
Yeah, I'm trying here. I'm trying to mimic the chef, but trust me, I do not know how the chef holds this pot handle and not feel anything. I guess it comes with experience and time.
Yes.
Wonderful.
You'll get there one day.
I'll get there. I spend some more time around you, Chef Nico, and I'll be there. I don't all think right. I give it the full mix, so you might want to do that. Oh, you have a you see, you have
yeah.
I missed that one. Look how this looks good.
Perfect.
Chef, I'm going to be making this as a normal dish at my home. Yeah, I hope you know that.
Of course.
Yeah, and it's quite simple.
Of course.
I like this. Absolutely.
All right, so we're ready to plate.
We're ready to plate.
Yeah.
We take a break. We'll be coming back. When we come back, we'll be sharing some of this amazing food. We're going to be doing some sampling. We've got a team DBS up in here. They're going to be having some sampling. We're going to plate some food. And when we come back, well, you're not going to have only my word for it. You're going to get reviews from the rest of the DBS team.
That's right.
Lady, we give you delicious and nutritious milk. We make sure our milk is filled with essential nutrients, calcium, vitamins, and protein. Dutch Lady gives everyone in the family a strong start to the day. Keep your family healthy and happy. Dutch Lady, building strong families since 1871.
Did you know that calcium in milk is not only important for building up your bones and teeth, but also for your muscles and for transmitting nerve impulses?
Of course, this is executive chef, so we're not just serving food just like that. We got to make sure we plate food. I'm big on plating foods.
That's right.
And to me, food's supposed to look presentable.
Yeah, that's
you
right.
know, so I am quite interested to see how you're going to plate this awesome dish. Let's get into it.
You look like you give up on me. Eh?
No, not yet. No? Not. I'll be there. You know, after the plating. Trust me, I'll be there with my cutlery. You best believe that.
Right,
oh, that's so. A nice avocado. Yeah. You got this here at the market?
Yeah, this morning.
Wow, Chef Nico, what time you go to the market? Now let me learn from the chef, because apparently when I go to the market,
right.
I get all of the burnt out stuff. So if I want the real chef material, I have to go what time?
Okay, so the market, every Saturday I go to the market. I leave home at 4:30 so that I can reach by the market at least.
Now you see my problem?
Five after five.
First problem.
This is where you get the good stuff.
The good stuff. This is a beautiful anchor.
Yeah.
Wow.
Green fig was a struggle to get, you know?
Yeah.
And by the market normally has some green fig, but not much, you know? And that's the right time you have to go if you need some green fig.
Uh-huh.
You know? Yeah, so early.
Now, Chef, I've never seen that. I'm wondering why you're cutting the avocado from the little... Like,
yeah.
Why are you cutting the little little bottom part of it?
Doing some
that's
nice
just for it to sit.
Right. So, you know, when you plate food, you have to do it with love. You know,
absolutely.
You
that's one of my favorite. I love avocados.
Yes.
I love avocados. I wish you could have avocados all year round. You know, actually, it's one of my favorite foods. I love avocados. This is a beautiful avocado.
Yeah, it is.
Do you know, Chef, is there a way to identify... Because you found this one, you know,
yeah.
And you didn't have to cut into it first. I'm not very good at picking them. When
right.
I go home, I normally look and they don't have the right color inside, or they don't...
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
How
as
do you know?
Say, the color, sometimes you see mm-hmm. that way and you're thinking, okay, that's the best.
Yeah.
But you have to check the texture from the outside.
Right.
Make sure it's not that soft.
So there is a way to identify.
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to learn that before I leave as well. I'm all for that. I'm working with you.
Yeah, definitely.
You're wonderful. Now, there's something else, Chef. When you mm-hmm. were doing the actual prepping,
right?
When you were placing the lemons or the lime in the fish, you did not put it like most of us in our home cooking do. We put the lime and we leave it in the fish for eons. I realize you just put a dash of it just before you're ready to put it in the pot. Was that
Right, you know, things like lime, vinegar, you know, those citrus, you know, it's like, you know, if you're doing a Mitsubishi, you can use it, but last minute.
Right.
But if you use it beforehand, it's going to cook the fish.
Ah, especially it's going to get too tough.
Right.
Right, so you don't want to do that. So, okay, yeah. That's a no-no. Moving forward, I've learned this. You guys should learn that as well. Right. So we're plating, we've got some avocado on the plate. Our Suska is nice and sitting over there. We've got some garnish. By the great chef. And that's my Suska, by the way, guys. Please remember that. Okay, so that's our little mash with our breadfruit mash with saltfish.
You always use a style of ice cream scoop.
Yeah, this is so presentation.
That's right.
Absolutely. I love this. Right. Nice. Wow.
All right, so the good stuff now is the fish, right?
Okay, so that's going to be the biggest part. It's going to take up the biggest part on the plate. I said I wasn't sharing with our camera guys, but ooh, look this, simple like that. Look how cute this looks.
Yes.
The aroma, I can't stop talking about the aroma up in here. It smells so good. So good. Would you serve kawang at the top?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Of course.
Why not?
Yeah, okay, it's different. Just fillet, take out the bones, and
right.
Voila, there you go.
There you go. Right. So it's not the ingredient, it's how you prepare
right.
it.
That's right.
Right. So it's a top chef, you would know that.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. And we're going to garnish everything with the Suska?
Yeah, so your fish and the avocado, so it's almost like a vinaigrette also, so you can use that part of it
right.
to give your avocado the cook it.
Right. Normally, you hear chef talk about tying it together. Is that what ties the plate together?
That's right. That's right.
Garnish. This is one of my favorite
seasonings. Yes. Yeah, same there. Shadow Benny. So we get that locally. And Shadow Benny, there's a lot of people that have been by their home and they have that in the backyard and they don't know how important it is. It tastes just like cilantro.
Right.
And last time, you know, we had a chef competition and I was telling the chefs, you buy cilantro, it's overseas. How much money
it's a lot of
we
money.
Have
yeah.
that going in our backyard. The Trinis love that.
Oh, that's our thing. The Trini side of me. They always chat for this one. Yeah, we put it in everything. Certainly does. Ooh. Guys, you see how this plate is coming together? You see how this is? Oh, what's this? Is that rosemary?
Yes.
Oh, that's a huge rosemary. At the market as well?
No, that's in like the backyard, this one.
Oh, you've got those. Do you plant some of your own stuff?
Yeah, I have herbs.
Right.
In my garden.
Is it out of a need or is it out of like, you know?
It's just for home.
For home, yeah? It brings you some level of calm?
That's right.
Right. Look how beautiful this. That looks Creole-y. Yeah, it does, isn't it? Yeah, now that we start, it start coming together, it does look a lot Creole-y.
Beautiful colors.
Beautiful colors. That's all I like my colors, yeah. I feel like I blend in right now.
Yeah.
I feel like I blend right in with this. Right. So we're going to take this to our serving table now.
Yes.
Take it to our serving table now. And get some, why not? Selfie? Wonderful. Guys, this is what we just cooked up with Chef Nico.
Yes.
On our first episode.
Right.
MANJÈ KAYÈ.
Creole dish with a twist.
Creole dish with a twist. Yeah. I like this. Absolutely love this.
All right.
We take a break. Next up, we're going to be sampling.
Dutch Lady, we give you delicious and nutritious milk. We make sure our milk is filled with essential nutrients, calcium, vitamins, and protein. Dutch Lady gives everyone in the family a strong start to the day. Keep your family healthy and happy. Dutch Lady, building strong families since 1871.
DBS Manjè Lakay, brought to you by Peter & Company Distribution, agents for Dutch Lady, Eve, Roberts, Swiss, Moses & Lion, also Oktoberfest. Did you know that vitamin B12 is only found in animal products such as milk? This makes milk even more important for people who do not eat meat.
There you go. So I'm learning now.
Yeah.
I love that. I wouldn't have thought.
Yeah. There you go.
And
great
here
job.
We go. Great job. Hey. Got right. This. Yay.
Yes.
Yay, yay. Wow.
Yes, yes.
Well, I'm ready to dive in.
Yes.
Who's yeah. Having? I told the camera guys they're not having any. I'll buy them food on the way down. So let's sample it. Let's get it. Let's dig in there. Oh, there we go. Wonderful. Taste down. Time for tasting.
Right.
All right. Oh,
Jesus
guy, right? Oh, you probably need to. Well, I thought you were gonna serve me. That's fine.
Ah.
Yeah, I'm asking for too much now. Right. Well, a little Jesus guy on there.
That's really good.
Oh.
Beautiful.
Oh.
Nice and moist, you know, just the right texture, you know what he's looking for.
It's got a nice balance. I mean, okay, no, I'm not even sure. I'm actually eating.
Right.
But it's nice. It's a different angle.
Right, right.
To what I usually eat for kawa.
Okay.
The mango gives it a really lovely kick.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. Mm. Mm. This now, very interesting.
So rich.
I have not tasted it since you put the little pepper in the cake. So, my first time with the pepper.
So rich.
Oh,
so beautiful.
This is heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
And it just flavored it. It's right. Not hot.
Mm-hmm.
It just gives a little kick. Ah, I love this. This is going to become a favorite. A little avocado in there.
There you go again. Good job.
This is a beautiful dish.
Good
job. I would pay money for that at a top restaurant. I will.
A lot.
Mm.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Wow. Voila. Mm. Dutch Lady was our ingredient, our special ingredient today. Of course, PCD, Peter & Company Distributors, is our partner on board with this. So thank you, PCD.
Uh-huh.
We'll see you on the next one. Chef Nico, job well done. This is
yes.
This is amazing. I can't wait for the next one.
Yes.
All right, good. We're going to be eating some more. Guys, I might just share. Might just share now. If you get here in time. Until next time. That's it. Manjè Lakay.
DBS Manjè Lakay, brought to you by Peter & Company Distribution, agents for Dutch Lady, Eve, Roberts, Swiss, Moses and Lion, also Oktoberfest.
You're watching DBS,